friends, today a very important necessitation for those who are preparing for interviews of lecturer. And I believe that this interview would definitely helpful for those teachers who may be having plans to go for school, colleges, that doesn't matter at all. Wherever they go, they will feel that this session would be helpful. Definitely the question which would be asked at their time also when they would be performing the same interviews. So let us see and practice this interview, learn so many things from it. My team is ready? Are you comfortable?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Mr. Gajender, you are already a first grade teacher and now you want to be a professor, isn't
yes, sir.
It? Of
yes,
college. Okay. So, we want you to first give your complete introduction and then we'll start our questionings. Please.
I am Gajender Verma.
Right.
And I am from Sri Ganganagar district of Rajasthan. And at present, I am lecturer in English in Government Senior Secondary School 13FF Karanpur, Tehsil and district Ganganagar. And I am a lecturer since 2012.
Okay.
I have been teaching English there in the government school. And before joining as a lecturer, I was a third grade teacher. And I was selected in 2005. So, and I am from Ganganagar. I live in Ganganagar. And there are four members in my family. My house, my wife is also a teacher.
Okay. So, you believe that your wife is also a teacher and you are also a teacher. So, definitely teaching is in your blood, isn't it? Don't move your body again and again. Your wife is also a teacher. So, teaching is in your blood, don't you feel so?
Yes, sir, I feel
so. What about your parents?
Yes, my father was also a teacher. He was
That's
a teacher
great.
Of social science. And in the beginning, in the childhood, it was my desire to be a teacher.
Oh,
so,
that's nice.
Since childhood, I wanted to be a teacher and it was grace of God on me that I fulfilled my dream.
Okay.
And now I'm here for the post of assistant professor.
Okay, that's wonderful. So I have brought today a list of certain questions in my mobile. And I want my colleague also that I have given certain questions of HR questions to you also. So, shall we start the questionings?
Oh,
okay. See, today I have brought certain questions from you. And these questions are the parts of speech and I want you to first explain what is allegory. Can you explain?
Yes, sir. Allegory is a figure of speech which is used in literature. And when we are telling a story,
okay,
so it has two meanings. On the surface meaning, it is the meaning which it is showing.
Okay.
And it can have another meaning also. The characters in the story can represent other persons also.
Right.
So if a writer is unintentionally want to satirize someone, but he doesn't want to directly name him, then he can represent him in his story by showing an evil character.
Okay.
There are many examples of allegory in English literature. We have a perfect allegory as Absalom and Achitophel written by Dryden, in which he satirized his enemies. And Spencer's Fairy Queen is also a very famous allegory.
Okay.
So allegory is a tool for the writers to satirize or to vindicate or to show their vindication against their enemies.
And what is alliteration?
Alliteration is a figure of speech in which the writer
yes.
uses similar sounds.
Okay.
Whether it's of consonant sounds or whether it's repetition of vowel sounds.
Right.
And alliteration is mainly used to create a musical effect in poems.
Okay. Can you give me an example?
Yes, sir. Fair is foul and foul is fair from The Tempest. Full
okay.
fathom five, thy father lies.
Okay.
Is another also a line from The Tempest.
Okay. Please explain allusion.
Sometimes the writers in describing the story, in describing their work,
yes.
they take the help of another work which is very famous.
Okay.
In Hindu mythology, sometimes we use Mahabharata's episodes or Ramayana's episodes in order to clear our sense.
Okay.
In similar way, in English literature also, the writers have used famous writers' allusions, famous writers' quotations in their work. So that thing is in literature is called allusion.
And amplification?
Amplification when we are giving extra information about a sentence.
Okay.
We are giving extra information about a person or anything. That is called amplification. For example, I say that Ram, who is a teacher in my school,
okay.
is a very honest person.
Yes.
So in order to say that Ram is an honest person,
yes.
I am saying Ram who teaches in my school, that is amplification.
And anagram?
In anagram, we change the normal order, we change the order of the characters in order to make a new word.
Okay.
I am giving you an example. When we say credit card, we can make the new word bad credit by having the same characters.
Okay.
Credit card, bad credit.
Yes.
So when we change characters and the meaning changes, that is known
as
anagram.
That becomes an anagram. And analogy?
Analogy means similarity.
Okay.
When we are showing similarity in two things, that is called analogy.
Okay.
For example, if I say that, if somebody say that there is no rainbow without rain, similarly there is no success without hard work.
Yes.
So this is an analogy between rainbow and your result and hard work and rain.
Okay. So we have a colleague from Abohar, right? Bhavna Mittal, isn't it? Complete name.
Yes, sir.
And definitely we want that you should also have some questions from a professor who is going to be a professor soon, and he is a first grade lecturer. Do you have any HR questions as I stated in your mobile?
Yes, sir.
Please do ask.
I want to know your strengths, which is particularly required for this show.
Yes, at present I am here to become an assistant professor in English. So first of all, I think the thing which is necessary to be an assistant professor is the thorough knowledge of your subject.
Okay.
You must be a master of your subject.
Yes.
And I have studied very hard for the last 2 and 3 years. As you know, that process is going on since 2014.
Yes.
And I have been studying English literature since 2005 when I completed my MA. So I think I have the full, I am trying to get the full knowledge of my subject, and I am very enthusiastic about English literature. So I think this is my strength, and other strengths are I think I am very sincere to my work, and I am a perfectionist also.
Okay.
So I think I will not going to disappoint you if you select me.
Bhavna, what do you think? Like, what are the probable strengths which a person can share?
His confidence and level of caliber.
Okay. Any more?
Why he is particularly able for that job.
Yes. Main thing is that.
Yeah.
Like, which job he is going for. Yes. As per that, his or her strength should
be
shown.
He is ready for that job or not.
Yes. That's the main thing. More questions, please, from your side.
In your life, in your entire life, what was your biggest failure and why? Which you think that was failure?
I don't remember any big failure. I took some wrong decisions which I consider that those were failures. I didn't go for B.Ed. When I have the opportunity, I was selected, but I didn't go for it, and later I regretted my decision. And at present I don't remember that I have any great failures. Actually, failures are not that bad. Every person has some failures. But I think I'm lucky enough that I don't have.
Okay. Chali, let us come back on more figure of speech. What is anastrophe?
Anastrophe. Anastrophe.
The order of the noun and the adjective in the sentence are exchanged.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you very much for reminding me. When we change the normal order of an adjective and a noun, instead of saying that I am talking about the time past and time future.
Okay.
The normal order of the sentence is this, that I am talking about past time and future time, but I have changed the order of adjective and noun, time past and time future.
Okay.
And many other examples are there at present.
Anecdote means?
Anecdote means small stories which teaches us moral lesson.
Then what does fable means?
Fable also a kind of moral story, but in fable we have characters of animals who speak like humans.
Okay. Means non-living things also speaks.
Non-living, especially animals.
Okay.
In the jungle.
Okay.
Stories of Panchatantra.
Okay.
Are a perfect example of fables. Fables are also famous in English literature.
Okay. And what do you mean by the word anthropomorphism?
Anthropomorphism. It is a figure of speech when we change the when we change the
Human quality emotions to a non-human object. The act of lending a human element to a non-human subject is often employed in order to endear the later the reader or audience and increase the level of relativity between the two while also lending character to the subject.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. And what is antithesis?
Antithesis is a figure of speech in which we describe two opposite things and try to balance them, and we show a new meaning also.
Any example?
Yes, when I give example, the sense will be clear. Example is fair is foul and foul is fair.
Okay.
In which I have completely changed the order of the sentences, order of the words in the next second clause.
Okay.
And other example is man proposes and God disposes.
Okay.
Yeah, the opposite qualities here, that man makes plan, but the result is in the hand of God.
Okay. So Gajender, what does your name mean? Kya meaning hai aapke name ka?
In Hindi, Gajendra means king of elephants.
Okay.
And one other meaning is also there. The elephant of Lord Indra was, his name was Gajendra.
Okay. So what it symbolizes? What are the qualities?
It symbolizes physical power.
Okay.
And a chariot and a way of a journey for the Lord Indra.
Okay. Bhavana, don't we have the quality to touch our own quality with a particular, our own name? Like for example, if I tell you to elaborate your name, how you will say?
My name means good feelings or emotions, and I'm actually very much similar to
yes,
my name.
Yes, this line I want to hear from you, that I'm always similar to my name.
Yeah.
And this should be a correlation, we should have a good correlation. So how?
And there
how
must you, be a reason also.
How if
yes,
I...
Yes, I'm an empathetic girl. Main kisi ki bhi feelings easily carry kar sakti hun, samajh sakti hun. Aur patience bhi hai.
So it is correlating your
yeah.
feelings, your bhavana means.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. So we should have the quality of this quality. Okay, it looks better. And Chaliyan, what does the aphorism mean?
Aphorism means when we are expressing our ideas in very small sentences and using very less amount of words. That device is known as aphorisms. Bacon was famous for his aphorisms because he expressed his views in very condensed sentences, in very compact sentences.
Okay. And assonance means what?
Assonance means repetition of vowel sounds.
Okay.
For example, a long song.
Yes.
In which the vowel sound O is repeated, long and song.
Okay. So Bhavana, any more HR questions you are having
yes,
in your brain? Please, you can.
Who is your role model and why?
There are many role models, not a single one. And I follow, there are various fields and various role models for me.
For example?
For example, Amitabh Bachchan is a role model for me because he shows me the strength and continuous working power. And in the field of cricket, MS Dhoni is my role model because he has grown up from a very humble background and he has continually showed his talent. And in teaching, my father is my role model. He always taught me good things which helped me to become a teacher.
Suppose you get a little far from your city job, no problem at all, or will you consider your home more?
No problem, sir. We are government servants and we are bound to go anywhere, wherever government asks us.
Okay, you don't have any problem?
No, sir.
With food and with water, language is no problem at all?
No, sir. The whole of India is my home and whole of Rajasthan is also my home.
Okay.
So wherever government wants me, I must go there.
Okay. Yes, any more question, Bhavana, from your side?
No, sir.
Okay. So what is your next 5-year plan of life? 5, 10, what are future plans?
After, if I am lucky enough to get an appointment of assistant professor, so my 5-year plan will be to dedicate myself completely to students.
Okay, that's wonderful.
I am a very avid teacher and I am a very avid learner of English.
Okay, what are your expectations from us? As
from
an
you,
interviewer,
I expect that you will select me.
Okay.
These are my
valid reason. Valid reason also should be given with that. Why should we select you?
I think I am quite suitable for this job and I have a good academic record.
Bhavana, how many candidates are waiting outside for the job?
Nearly
200. So 200 lecturers are in queue to be professors. So why should we select only this Gajender? There may be 2-3 Gajenders also who are having the same quality. So how you are different from others?
Sir, at present I cannot judge others who are waiting for interview.
Okay.
I cannot say that I am better or they are worse than me.
Okay.
But I am in front of you with my qualities and with my academic record and with my enthusiasm for teaching and with my experience.
Right.
So I think I cannot compare with anyone. You are a better judge. You can judge better. But I think you will judge a good person, a suitable person, and I am fully confident that I am quite suitable.
Actually, who among both of you, both of us, between both of us, whom you found a better judge?
No, I cannot compare to you also. I think both of you are good.
Okay.
You are well qualified, and that's why RPSC has appointed you to take interview.
Okay.
So I cannot judge in the span of 5 or 10 minutes that who is better. I think both of you are excellent.
See what happens. Sometimes interviewers ask us questions.
Yes.
That among us 5 members, between 2 of us, whom you like the most, who is better? And sometimes because of innocence, person say, sir, you are asking more questions, so definitely you are more intelligent, right? So it's right that what you said, you should not answer every question. A smile is enough for that.
Yes.
That, no sir, I think both are having its own problem.
Diplomatic.
Yes, you should be, otherwise they will catch you. What do you mean by the word bibliomancy?
Bibliomancy, sorry sir, I am not able to recall it.
Okay, definite. Don't worry, you go through the word and you will learn it. And my next question to you is cacophony.
Cacophony is a figure of speech. It's a negative figure of speech. Whenever there is cacophony, it is the repetition of harsh sound in literature.
Okay.
Those sounds which are not pleasant to our ears, that becomes cacophony in literature.
And circumlocution means what?
Circumlocution means when a writer is saying in a roundabout manner, when he can express his ideas, his views in a shorter sentence, he is explaining these in 2 or 3 lines of sentences. For example, if we want to say that the month of November, and we can also say that the penultimate month of the year.
Okay.
So a writer can easily
unnecessarily
say that
he is increasing the words. Connotation means what?
There are 2 meanings of a word. One is the dictionary meaning and second is the implied meaning.
Okay.
So when we use the words not literally, when we are using the word for its implied meaning, then it becomes connotation.
And denotation means what?
Denotation means the literal meaning of a word.
Okay. An example?
If I am saying that you are like rose.
Okay.
So it doesn't mean literally that you are rose. It means that you are as beautiful as a rose. So the rose word connotes beauty and softness.
Okay.
And we are not using here the word rose literally.
Okay. So what do you think, Bhavna? What are the probable strengths which you found in Gajender till yet?
He's a confident person, and fluency in English is really good.
Okay. So as our viewers must be watching us, and they may be learning so many things, and we invite our viewers for the 7 days program, and you know very well that people are reaching here and gaining success. So many lecturers you have seen, now they are doing job. People from Delhi, Mumbai, Pune have visited here. You must have seen their videos. If not, you go through previous videos, you will find those people and see how they got successful, and today they have attained their success. The same case here. If you want, definitely. But if you still feel that, sir, I'm having my family problems, I'm a housewife, or I'm a job person, I'm doing job, so you can avail the benefit of telephone preparations also. That can also be option. And other than that, we have our own books. So although we know very well that there are abundance of figure of speech which I'm having in my mobiles, which can't be asked on a very one day. But whatever questions we have asked from Mr. Gajender, he has answered well,
yeah.
Right? So what do you think about the qualities of Gajender? Kya laga? What are the best qualities which you found in his interview?
The main thing was his experience.
Okay.
He's working since 2012, and that's a great thing which we require.
Which
for
I don't also,
yeah.
In his job. And they will also consider this thing.
Yeah.
Yes.
And he's adaptable to any culture.
Yes.
He's not bound to his
As
family.
He stated that Kashmir,
yeah.
To Kanyakumari is same for me.
Same.
That is also a good,
yeah.
Point.
That was a good point.
So it shows that being a versatile person, he can easily adjust himself any part of the India. And wherever he gets a job, he don't have any problem, right? So we believe that all the qualities shows that he will definitely get selected, right? So it's right time to give him best wishes, and I hope my viewers much have learned so many things. So blessings to you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.